minute warm up. And then we're gonna demo the movements for our workout. And then we're gonna get right into that workout. We have 5 exercises. We're gonna be working for 1 minute, resting for 1 minute, going through those 5 exercises. Hopefully I can remember what all those exercises are. I think, maybe, well, figure it out. Whatever we do, that's what the new workout will be if we forget something, all right? So, no strength work at the beginning. We're gonna focus on moving through some yoga flow and then getting that body warmed up and then going through the movements for the workout and then getting right into that workout. So it'll be, like I said, 5 exercises, 1 minute of work, 1 minute of rest. So each round is gonna be 10 minutes long. So 3 rounds of that is gonna be right at that 29, 30 minute mark, all right? So let's go ahead and we're gonna start standing up, feet underneath the hips, take a nice deep breath in, reach up, right hand, grab the left wrist, and we're gonna keep that chest open to the front of the room and pull to the side. Breathe into this side body right here. And come up, left hand, grab the right wrist, pull to the other side. And you don't necessarily have to grab that wrist. You could just reach across the body. I'm just assisting myself a little bit this morning. Reach up nice and tall. Forward fold all the way down. Let your head and shoulders hang heavy. Tucking your chin in towards your chest a little. Slight bend in the knees. Just let the weight of your head and your shoulders stretch your back out. About 3 deep breaths here. Take a nice deep breath in, all the way back up. Reach up, right hand, grab the left wrist, pull to the right side. Grab that other wrist, pull to the other side. Reach up nice and tall, forward fold again. Crossing the arms this time, letting the shoulders and head hang heavy still. About 3 or 4 deep breaths here. And then start to sway side to side about 10 to 15 times here. A little ragdoll action. And then we're slowly gonna make our way to our ground. So plant those hands on the ground. Step back, we're gonna come down to a tabletop. Hands are underneath the shoulders, knees are underneath the hips. Extend your right arm all the way out, thumb facing up. Straighten your left leg out, driving the heel back and then making sure our hips are level to the ground. All right, so we're not necessarily lifting our leg up. We're just kicking it straight back here. Okay, keep your belly button pulled in. Pull your elbow and your knee together, press them together, actually touch them together, pressing them together, crunching them together, creating some tension, creating some heat. And then extend them both out, and then back in, and we're gonna do 5 reps here. Set those hands and knees back down. Going to the other side, left arm up, thumb up in the air, straighten the right leg back. Make sure those hips are even. Bring the elbow and knee together, press them together. Extend all the way out, lengthening the arm and the leg, and then 5 reps.
bring those hands and knees down. Now we're gonna go into just some quick cat-cows here. So take a nice deep breath in. Push your hips back, chest up, hands into the floor. And then on your exhale, bring those hips underneath you or underneath your shoulders as much as you can. Get as much height out of the spine as possible. Possibly shift side to side depending on how tight you are. And then back to that cow. And then exhale into cat. Cow. Cat. Cow. We're gonna do two more here. Back into our cow one more time. Then cat. And then from here, we're gonna go ahead and step back into plank and slowly lower ourselves to the ground. Extend your arms out in front of you, or overhead, sorry. And then we're going to bring the thumbs facing up, bring your arms up off the ground, pull your shoulders back and down, and just hold here. Slowly take your hands out into a Y. Slowly bring them down into a T, pulling your shoulders down your back even more. Bring your hands in towards your head, temples, making a W. And then flip those hands down, keep them off the ground. Pulling down with your fingertips, pulling those shoulders down your back even more, getting a stretch through the traps, maybe even your neck. And then swim it up into an I, thumbs facing up, into a Y, into our T, into our W, back into our A. Swim it all up nice and slow into an I, Y, T, W, and A. Two more, swim it all the way up. I, Y, T, W, A. One more all the way up. I, Y, T, W, and A. All right, swim it all the way back up. So we're gonna do alternating Supermans here. So right arm, left leg. Left arm, right leg, okay? Driving the heel up, just 10 times here, nice and slow. And now we're gonna do 10 double Supermans, both arms, both feet. Set it back down nice and slow, back up. Back down nice and slow. This pace right here for 10 reps. And then our last one, bring those hands under your hip or underneath your shoulders and chest. Flip your toes, press up into a plank, and then into our downward dog. Pedal this out a little bit here, 10 times. Nice and slow, really driving those heels to the ground. Shift that weight back into plank. Slowly lower down into that push-up or all the way down to the ground. Flip up into an up dog or a cobra. Flip your toes. Back into downward dog. Flip the right heel up. Left heel driving it to the ground. Set that right foot down.
Left heel up, driving the right heel into the ground. Set that left foot down. Shift back to plank. Slowly lower down into that up dog or cobra. Flip your toes into downward dog. Right, float your right heel up, drive the left heel down. Bring that right knee to the right elbow, keep your foot off the ground. Back to our 3-point. Bring that right knee to the left elbow, cross the body. Back up into our 3-point here, and then swing that leg through in between our hands and sink into that lunge. Two or three deep breaths here. Let that stretch take place in the hip flexors and the groin. All right, we're gonna straighten the front leg, lift the toe, set it back down, back into our lunge. We go four times here. You can almost guarantee every time we do this, we're either gonna do some type of deadlifting or squatting. Just do one more. When we come back into our lunge, plant that left hand on the instep of that right foot and reach up. Then bring that right hand down where the left hand was. Reach up to the other side. We're gonna go side to side here, three times on each side. At your pace, nice and slow though. Take your time with it. And if you're with us on Friday, I think you know what's coming. We're gonna go from this position here. We're gonna push off at that back toe into a balance up onto our right foot. If you need to tap down, and go right into our single leg touchdowns. 10 times here. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take that left leg that's in the air and we're gonna step back into our lunge today. Okay, hands to the ground. Plant those hands, step back into our plank. Slowly lower yourself to the ground. Back into our up dog or cobra. Flip those toes into back into our downward dog. Float that left heel up, drive your right heel to the ground. Left knee to left elbow, shifting the weight forward. Swing it back up into our 3-point. Come across the body. Swing it back up. And swing that leg through into our runner's lunge on the other side. Oh, that's tight. Couple more breaths here. All right, now straighten that front leg, lift that toe, back into our lunge. Each time trying to get our knee forward a little bit more without that heel popping up off the ground. So trying to get some ankle mobility here while we're stretching the groin and hip flexors. Couple more. Last one, coming into that lunge, and like we did before, pressing off of that back toe, up into our balance, and then 10 single leg touchdowns here.
just like we did on the last one, we're taking that foot, stepping back into our lunge, hands to the ground, step back into plank, slowly lower ourselves back down to the ground, into an up dog or cobra, flip the toes, downward dog one more time, shift the plank, 20 mountain climbers. Back to downward dog. Walk your feet to your hands, and then stand all the way up and shake that out. All right, arms out to the side here, fingertips down. A few big circles just to continue loosen up those shoulders. We do have a little overhead work, some pushing overhead, some horizontal and vertical pushing. In reverse. I already have a puddle. We haven't even finished the warm-up yet. All right, alternate back and forth 10 times. Both hands, front to back, 10 times. And then side to side, 10 times. All right, and roll that out a little bit. All right, so I'm gonna demo this a couple different ways. That way, if you have a dumbbell at home, you'll know how to approach the workout. Right, so we're gonna start off with sumo deadlift high pulls. All right, so we're gonna widen our feet out outside of our shoulders. Our toes are going out, all right? And then when we do our deadlift, we're driving our hips back. And then as we come up, we squeeze our butt and pull at the same time. So we're driving our hips forward just like a deadlift. And we're using the power from those hips to help pull the weight up to our chest. It doesn't have to come up to your face, all right? It actually shouldn't pass your chin or your collarbone. You should be pulling right up to your collarbone. You don't have to pull way up here like this, okay? It should be hands are at the chest, elbows are about ear level, and we're not overextending those shoulders and creating more of an impingement there, all right? Some of you may be in this position right here based on mobility. All right, and what's comfortable. If for some reason you have any shoulder issues on that pulling motion, then I would go ahead and do a swing instead. All right, we're still getting that work through the hips. You can widen your feet out so you can almost do like a wide leg swing. You can come here and do your swings like this, okay? But what that sumo deadlift looked like from the side, all right, our shoulders are back, we're driving those hips back and pulling right here, all right? We're not squatting and doing this. We're driving our hips back, activating those hamstrings. If you have a lighter weight, you'll be in the same position. Your non-working hand will be out to the side. We're gonna go into our deadlift. You don't have to touch the ground. I want the shoulders to stay above the hips, and then you'll pull on one side for 30 seconds, and then go to the other side for 30 seconds, all right? Then we're gonna rest a minute. Then we're gonna go to, see if I can remember, push-ups, all right? So we're gonna do push-ups for a minute. Again, our setup on our push-ups, if we're laying on the ground, we take our hands, place our thumbs right below our chest, and then bring our hands out to the side. That way we have a nice vertical shin or a vertical forearm here. Our elbows don't go out to the side. They go back towards our body. About a 30 to 45 degree angle. Squeeze your butt and press. Keep your core tight as you come down. Squeeze your butt and press. All right? Squeezing your butt and pressing enables your hips to come up with your shoulders. All right? Again,
If you have issues pressing and your shoulders come up first and your hips stay on the ground, that's a core engagement issue. So what I want you to focus on is the negative part of the push-up. So staying engaged all the way down, and then resetting, and then going all the way down again, all right? You'll get 5 to 7 of those in a minute time frame if you do them slow enough and controlled enough. All right, then we have a minute rest. Then we go into jumping lunges or reverse lunges or alternating lunges, all right? This all depends on where you are today. I don't know how my ankle's gonna feel, so I may end up doing reverse lunges with people. But we're gonna be in this position here. We're coming up, switching your feet, and we're going for a minute. Okay, some of us may make it 30 seconds and then have to go to lunges for 30 seconds. Right? Then we're going back to our weight for push press. If you have a single weight, just like the sumo deadlift high pull, I want you to do 30 seconds of push press on one side. If your weight is really light, just do a strict shoulder press and don't use your legs at all. And then at 30 seconds, we'll switch to the other side. If you have that heavier torpedo weight, same thing. Push press, or if you have a lighter one, that's still too heavy to do with a single arm, just do a shoulder press, okay? If you really wanna challenge yourself and you have moderate weight, you can put a dumbbell in each hand and do it that way as well, all right? So we have our push press. Then we'll rest 1 minute and then we go into our squatting. All right, we got goblet squats right after our push press, going all the way down and then standing, all right? Very simple movements today, very effective movements today. I'm gonna do this workout a couple different ways, if I remember, just so people can see what it looks like as we go through. I'm gonna start out with the single torpedo weight though. All right, so go ahead and grab a sip of water. And once we get started, we'll be working for a minute, resting for a minute, for approximately 30 minutes. Going through the whole thing 3 times. All right. I've stalled enough. Stalling for me, not you. Going in 10 seconds here. Sumo deadlift high pulls, get those feet out wide, toes are out. All right, and here we go. Coming down. Notice I'm not touching the ground. You don't need to touch the ground. You just need to feel tension in your hamstrings and then drive those elbows up. Notice the weight is just coming right to my clavicle, the collarbone area, okay? You don't have to pull it up and almost hit yourself in the nose or the forehead. It actually can become problematic if you do it too often with too heavy of weight. 30 seconds. Seconds. And rest. Shake those arms out. Ooh. We're going to be going to push-ups next. So getting rid of that weight for a little bit. Never bad that first minute. My body's telling me I should have moved and been more active this weekend. It's literally telling me you did not move enough. All right. Going in 5 seconds here, you keep your core tight, and go. We're doing as many reps as we can here.
again.
I'd rather have 10 good reps than 30 bad reps, all right? So take your time on these. It's the first round.
Still have about 15 seconds. And rest.
Ooh. As simple as push-ups are, they will fatigue you out faster than anything, I think.
Shake those arms out. Going back to our legs with no weight, jumping lunges or reverse lunges. Remember reverse lunges? I put my hands up on my shoulders here, elbows up. You can step back like that. If you can't do the jumping lunges, or if you're doing the jumping lunges and it just gets to be too much, just modify to that. It's a minute of jumping lunges, so your legs are gonna be on fire. All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1, and go. Already. Might have to get a mat. I'm already sliding. So we got 20 seconds here. And rest. Oh man. That's just mean putting those in the middle. How many did you get? 20, 30, 35, 40? You want to try to stay consistent with those if you can, each round. Taking it off our legs this time and going to push press or shoulder press, wherever you are. So you got about 25 seconds. Grab your weight. 3, 2, 1, and go. I'm gonna start off with shoulder press and see if I need to go to a push press. The answer to that is gonna be yes. I'm gonna need to go to a push press. Whew. 30 seconds. Whew. 10 seconds. And rest. Forgot to say it before, but if you can't go overhead, you should be doing bent over rows. That was my fault.
Oh man. 30 seconds. We're going to our goblet squats. This will end our first round. All right, go ahead and get in your squat stance. Grab your weight. Make sure your feet are even. And here we go. Seconds. Seconds. And rest. I am struggling today. Those of you that are using one weight, I'm going to come to you now. Sumo Deadlift pulls. Always start with that non-dominant side if you're using one arm at a time. And go. Remember, still doing a deadlift here. Driving those hips back, keeping our back nice and flat, putting tension on the hamstrings. Not our backs. And switch it up. Seconds. And rest. Oh. Push-ups are next. Sorry, I'm dying this morning. Not enough water, not enough sleep, not enough movement. All that plays a role in how you feel. So, makes sense to me, especially today. Ooh. All right, so we got 15 seconds here. I'm gonna shake my arms out here, get my shoulders and triceps ready for just pushing. Go ahead and make your way to the floor. 3, 2, 1, and go. Go to your knees if you need to go to your knees. If you need to do hand and release push-ups, teeing your hands out to the side.
30 seconds. Finding a dry spot to do push-ups. A little challenging. Oh, 10 seconds. And rest. Oh. All right, we got about 30 seconds here. We're making our way back to our feet for our jumping lunges or reverse lunges or alternating lunges. All right, 5 seconds. Here we go, going in 3, 2, 1, and go. Oh. 10 seconds. And rest. Ooh. Seconds. All right, going to our shoulder press or push press. Again, if you're doing one arm at a time, start with that non-dominant arm and go. And 30 seconds. And rest. Oh. So we got 30 seconds here.
Oh man.
Make sure your feet are even. Make sure one foot's not in front of the other when you're doing your squats here. Something I have to take notice of is I'll let my left foot slide back a little bit more than my right. Here we go. And go. Sorry, 20 seconds left. I couldn't breathe. And rest. I literally was trying to say 30 seconds. I couldn't do it, sorry. Like I said, I'm struggling this morning, but we're getting it in. Even when you're not feeling the best, that's actually one of the most important times to work out. Force yourself to do it. As long as you're safe about it. All right. Coming up on our last round. We got 10 seconds. It felt like much of a rest to me. Widen those feet out. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, and go. If this starts to bother your shoulders, just do sumo deadlifts, like that. Just like that. Shoulders are gonna get tired. Seconds. One more rep. And rest. Oh my God. Oh. Oh man, we got 30 seconds here before we get to our last set of push-ups. If you have a slick floor like I do, find a dry spot. Get to it. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, and go. Ooh. 20 seconds. And rest. Oh. Going to our jumping lunges. Or reverse lunges. You can actually do a split squat as well, where you split your feet out into a lunge position and just squat up and down for 30 seconds, and then switch to the other side for 30 seconds. Non-impact. Oh man, 10 seconds. Going by way too fast. All right, here we go. Going in 3, 2, 1, and go. Goodness, 30 seconds. Ten seconds. And rest. Oh my God. Two more exercises. Huh. 30 seconds. Not recovering. Huh. It's so hot in here. 5 seconds. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, and go. Oh, 30 seconds. Oh. Rest. Oh. Oh my God. We got 1 more minute coming up. It's our goblet squat. Oh. Seconds.
All right, 10 seconds. Start making your way to your weight. Oh my God. Last minute. Here we go, 3, 2, 1, and here we go. Seconds. Ten seconds. Take a minute here. Oh, shit. Take that right arm, come across the front, pulling the shoulders down away from the ears. Whew. And take that front hand behind your shoulder blades, pull back. And then reach up, reach to the side. Shake that out. Oh my God. Still can't breathe. Left arm across the front. Take the hand between the shoulder blades, pull back. Whew. Reach that arm up, reach the side. Grab your hands behind your back. Press down the back. Right ear, right shoulder. Left ear, left shoulder. Oh, you guys keep stretching. I'm busy. People gotta look at the workout and be like, ha ha, that don't look like too bad. Until you do it. Doing it and looking at it are two totally different things. All right, make our way down to the floor. Pull both knees into the chest here. Just rock back and forth a couple times. Grab that right knee, straighten the left leg all the way out. Take that left hand on the outside of the right knee, pull across the body. Oh. Few deep breaths here. Bring that knee back in towards your chest. Set the foot down on the ground. The left knee over the right ankle. Left hand on that left knee. Press all the way down as far as you can with that left knee until you get some tension. And now we're going to push against the hand and then rest and press. No, don't give way to that knee and push against the hand again. And try to get a little bit more distance. A couple more times here. Just opening that hip up a little bit. Pull both knees into the chest again. Rock back and forth 3 or 4 times. Keep a hold of that left leg. Straighten the right leg all the way out.
right hand across that left leg, pull across the right body. Looking out over the left shoulder, left fingertips. 3 to 5 deep breaths here. Bring that back up to the top, pull both knees in, take that right knee across the left, or right ankle across the left knee, my bad. Right hand across the right knee, or on the right knee. Press until you feel tension and the knee won't go any further away from the body. Then press that knee against your hand and see how much more we can get out of that stretch. Press against the hand, a little bit more, press against the hand. A little bit more, press against the hand, and a little bit more. There you go. Pull both knees into the chest one more time here. All right.